Hey everybody, and welcome to episode 4 of Can we talk about your WordPress projects? It's the theater person in me. I can't not do the accent. So here's where I'm giving you advice on all things project management related to WordPress projects. In the last couple of episodes, and in this episode, and maybe in one or two more, what we're covering are those standard plans and processes that your agency or you as an individual provider need to have in place to have a good, solid project management approach for your WordPress projects. So far, we've talked about acceptance management, we've talked about client management, and today we're going to talk about issues and risk management. Now, some people might feel like, well, that's just overkill for a really small WordPress project, and it might be, but here's why you might want to consider having a risk management and an issues management plan in place all the time. Because it helps you get better at what you're doing. If you track the risks and how you mitigated them, or you track the issues and how they were handled, then you can keep those things from happening in the future. Now, first, let me explain the difference between a risk and an issue. A risk is something that might happen, and then what are you going to do about it? And you plan for that up front. An issue is when something occurs during the course of your project that needs to be dealt with. So that's how they're different. Let me give you an example. An example of a risk might be that the client may not get their content delivered on time because they're super busy and they have a business to run and they probably overestimated their ability to get the content done. And I could go on and on about that, but that is actually a risk to every single project. So it makes sense to list that in your proposal to the client and say, this is a risk. And if this risk occurs, here's what's going to happen. You might decide to put the project on hold if the client doesn't meet their dates. You might decide to charge a penalty. However you deal with the client not complying with the agreed upon schedule, then that's what would go in your risk management plan. Then for issues, you need to have a plan. And by putting this in your proposal, then the client knows that you're not just going to gloss over these things, that if an issue arises, you're going to document it, and then you're going to document how you're going to deal with it, and you're going to work with the client on how you're going to deal with it. An example of an issue might be that one of your developers was in an accident, and so they can't finish the project, and you can't find another one just like him, so you're having to use maybe a junior programmer. That's an issue, and it may have an impact to the schedule, and it may have an impact to the cost, but that's something that occurred during the project, not something you could have foreseen up front. So if you can foresee it up front, it's a risk, and you should mention it and figure out how you're going to manage it. And if it's an issue, you need to keep track of all those things and how you address the issue so that you can not make those mistakes in the future or plan for them in the future. Now, the elements of a good risk plan or a good issues plan are pretty much the same. Who's going to be able to identify a risk or an issue? Who's going to make the final decision on how they're handled? And where are they going to be documented? That's pretty much the three basic elements of a good risk plan and a good issues plan. So in the next episode, we're going to talk about probably the biggest one that people are concerned about, change management, and how to manage that. Now, if you want to learn more about how to manage WordPress projects more effectively, you can go to my website at wproadmaps.com. And if you want to make sure you get notified when the WordPress Project Managers Academy is released, that's a free membership program that'll be released in the next few weeks. And if you want to be kept informed, just go to wproadmaps.com/WPPMA. WordPress Project Managers Academy, WPPMA, and there's a form there that you can fill out. I hope you're enjoying these little snippets of how you can improve your project management approach on your WordPress projects. And until next time, stay productive, stay strong, and I'll see you soon.